Hello friends, welcome again. Friends, in our previous video lecture, we discussed different parts of speech of English language. And friends, today we want to discuss one very important topic of English grammar or English language, and that is different types of words. Friends, we know that in any language, verbs play a very important role. In fact, verb is considered as the heart and soul of a sentence. You cannot make a sentence without a verb. And that's why it's very important for us to understand different types of verbs used in English language. As you can see here on the screen, you know, verbs are mainly divided into two categories, lexical verbs and auxiliary verbs. We are going to discuss what is lexical and what is an auxiliary. But lexical verbs again can be divided into two categories, regular lexical verb and irregular lexical verb. In the same manner, you know, auxiliaries, they are also divided into two categories, primary auxiliary verb and modal auxiliary verbs. Again, these verbs can be divided into in a different manner, okay? Verbs can be transitive verbs and they can be intransitive verbs. Verbs can be finite verbs and they can be non-finite verbs also. So friends, in this video lecture, we are going to discuss all these different types of verbs and their functions in sentences. But before we move ahead, I request all my viewers to please subscribe to this channel so that whenever I upload a new video, you might get the notification. So friends, now let's begin. Types of verbs. As you can see here on the screen, verbs can be divided in three different manners, okay? Verbs can be transitive and intransitive. Verbs can be finite and non-finite. And they can be lexical and auxiliary. So friends, now let's see what a transitive verb is. Friends, the name itself tells us what a transitive verb is. Transitive means progressive, right? It has, the transitive verb has a definite object on which or for which some action is performed. You must have observed that in our English language, there are some sentences where you do not find an object, but there are some sentences where you see some objects, okay? We know that the sentence structure of English language is what? Subject, verb and object. But in some sentences, you do not see some objects. But when you see an object which follows the verb, that verb is known as a transitive verb. Say for example, Raju swallowed a tablet. Here, Raju is the subject, okay? Swallowed is a verb and a tablet is an object, okay? Now, if you observe, the verb swallow, okay, is followed by the object, a tablet. So, this verb which takes an object is known as a transitive verb. In the same manner, Rosie is painting a wall. Okay, here the verb is painting, which is followed by a noun or an object. Okay, a wall. So that's why the verb which takes an object is known as a transitive verb. So painting is also a transitive verb. In the same manner, just opposite to transitive verb, we have intransitive verb. Intransitive is the antonym of transitive. The intransitive verb does not take any object. You do not find any object after such verbs. Okay. Say, for example, Raju sneezed repeatedly. Okay. Here, the subject is Raju and the verb is sneezed. Okay. And after this verb, repeatedly is the time indicating words. Okay. It is a time indicating word which is not an object. So, the verb sneeze is not followed by any object. That's why you can say that this is an intransitive verb. In the same manner, Rosie is painting now. Here the verb is painting, but this verb painting is not followed by any object. When we say Rosie is painting a wall, here the verb painting becomes transitive verb, but when we say Rosie is painting now, here we do not have any object in this sentence, and that's why it is known as intransitive verb. So friends, remember this division of verbs, transitive and intransitive. Transitive verbs are those verbs which take some object in the sentence, and intransitive verbs are those verbs which do not have any object in the sentence. Okay. Now let's discuss another division of the verb, and that is finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Friends, what is finite verb? It is, in fact, the main verb in a sentence. Okay. And finite verb has some agreement with two things. Number one, subject, and number two, the tense. Right. So finite verbs, remember, they are the main verbs in the sentence which are found after the subject and which also go with the subject, with the type of subject which is used in the sentence, and the type of tense which is found in the sentence. Say, for example, when you say Raju sings well, here Raju is the subject, okay, and sings is the verb, and so sing is a finite verb. Why? Because sing, this verb, changes its form as per the tense and as per the subject. Okay. When you say Raju, then you have to use sings, S-I-N-G-S. But when you say Raju and Rosie, then the form of the verb is changed. You have to say Raju and Rosie sing well. In the same manner, when you use a past tense, then again the form is changed. You can't say sing. You have to use the verb sang, the past form of sing. Raju sang well yesterday. So a finite verb is the main verb which changes its forms considering who the subject is and considering what the tense is. Okay. Now the question is, what is a non-finite verb? Friends, remember, non-finite verbs are actually not the verbs. They look like verbs, but they do not act as verbs in the sentence. Okay, singing. Singing, we know, is a verb. Okay, when I say Raju sings well, here sing is the verb, but it is a finite verb. But when I say singing is Raju's hobby, then here the verb is not singing, the verb is. Singing is Raju's hobby. So singing is actually used as a subject, not as a verb. Right? So non-finite verbs are those verbs which look like verbs, but they act as subjects sometimes and sometimes as objects. You can see these two examples. Singing is Raju's hobby. Here the word singing is used as a subject. And Rosie likes painting. Here painting looks like a verb but is actually not a verb. So those verbs which are not actual verbs but they look like verbs in the sentence, they are known as non-finite verbs. Remember this. Okay, so friends, let me recollect. So far we have discussed two different categories of verbs, and they are transitive verbs and intransitive verbs, and finite verbs and non-finite verbs. Okay, now we discuss the last but very important category of verbs, and that is lexical verbs and auxiliary verbs, right? Friends, verbs can be divided mainly into these two categories, okay? And these two categories are lexical verbs and auxiliary verbs. Now the question is, what a lexical verb is? Friends, remember, the lexical verb is always used independently in a sentence, okay? It does not take the help of any other verb. They are independent in the sentence. They are just like your parents. Your parents are independent. That's why they are known as lexical people, okay? And you people, the students, the children, they are auxiliaries, right? Okay, why? Because you are dependent on your parents. So those who are dependent, they are known as auxiliary, and those who are independent, they are known as lexical verbs. Okay, now take this example. Raju lives in Delhi. Here the verb is lives, right? So lives is used independently in a sentence which does not require the help of other words or other verbs in this sentence, and this sentence is meaningful, right? So that's why the verb lives is a lexical verb. Okay, let's take another example. Rosie speaks English well. Here what is the verb? Speaks. And what type of verb is it? It is a lexical verb. But friends, remember, this lexical verb again can be divided into two different categories, and they are regular lexical verbs and irregular lexical verbs. Okay, now the question is, what is a regular lexical verb? It is very easy, friends. Okay, you know that, you know, when we use a verb in a sentence, we have to use different forms of verbs considering the tense, right? So each and every main verb has three different forms: play, played, played; cook, cooked, cooked; sing, sang, sung; run, ran, run. Okay, so each main verb, each lexical verb has three different forms. And friends, remember, what is a regular lexical verb? Whenever you use ed or ied in order to make the past form or the past participle form of that main verb, it is called a regular verb. Play, played, played. This is an example of a regular verb. But in English language, you must have come across some words which do not take ed or ied in their past and past participle forms. Okay, and such verbs are known as irregular lexical verbs. There are no rules, there are no norms to make the past or past participle form of such verbs. Such verbs are known as irregular lexical verbs. Say, for example, speak, then the past form is spoke and the past participle is spoken, right? Speak, spoke, spoken. So all three verbs, all three forms of this main verb speak are different. Okay, there are no rules. In the same manner, think, thought, talk. Here the last two forms are similar. Okay, taken another example, see, saw, seen. All three forms are different. Here, all three forms are different, and that's why these verbs are known as irregular. Okay, irregular lexical verbs. So friends, lexical verbs, verbs can be divided into two. Lexical verbs means the main verbs, and auxiliary verbs. Okay, auxiliary means helping verbs. Okay, now what is an auxiliary verb? An auxiliary verb is the verb which cannot be used independently in the sentence. As I just now told you, the children are dependent in the family, okay, and that's why children are known as auxiliary people, and parents are dependent, and that's why you can say parents are main people, lexical people in the family. Okay, now auxiliary verbs, okay, can be of two types: primary auxiliary and modal auxiliary. What is a primary auxiliary? The verb which sometimes is independent and sometimes is dependent. Okay, sometimes they seem to be independent in the sentence, and sometimes they seem to be dependent in the sentence. Such verbs are known as primary auxiliary verbs. Okay, let me give you an example. Like, there are three primary auxiliary verbs in English language, and they are be, do, and have. Okay, like there are different forms of be as per the different tense. If it is a present tense, then we have am, is, are. When it is a past tense, we have was and were. And if it is a future tense, we have shall be or will be. These are the different forms of be. Be is sometimes used independently in the sentence, sometimes used dependently in the sentence. Okay, and that's why be is known as primary auxiliary verb. In the same manner, we have three different forms of do. Okay, do, does, and did, right? And do, does, did, these three different forms also sometimes are independent and sometimes are dependent in the sentence. In the same manner, we have different forms of have, has, had, shall have, and will have. Let's take some examples, right? You can see on the left side there is a sentence, I am a student. Okay, here what is the verb? The verb is am, A-M, right? Here, this verb is independent. It does not take help of any other verb. It is used independently in a sentence. Okay, and what is an independent verb? Independent verbs are always lexical verbs. So here, the verb am is used as a lexical verb, but on the right hand side, you can see that the same am is not used independently. When you speak this line, I am learning English now. Now what is the verb? Learning is the main verb, and the verb am is used just to support the lexical verb learning. So here the verb am is used in a supporting role. It is not the main verb, and that's why you can say, you know, am, the verb am can be used independently on the left side, can be used dependently on the right side. The same is the case with the verb do. I do my work myself. Okay, so here do is independent. But when you on the right side, you see, I do not do my work. Here there are two do's. The first do is actually used to support the next do, right? In the same manner, we have a meeting today, right? It is independent, the verb have. But when you say, we have started the meeting, here the main verb is start. And have is used just to support the verb start. So have, do, and B, all these three can be sometimes independent, can be sometimes dependent. And that's why such verbs are known as primary auxiliary verbs. But we have another type of verb, another type of auxiliary verb, and that is modal auxiliary verb. Modal auxiliary, friends, is a verb which always are dependent on the main verbs. They can never be used independently in the sentence. They are always in a supporting role. They always are used as helping verbs in the sentence. And there are 10 different types of modal auxiliary verbs, like can, could, may, might, should, would, dare, need, used to, and ought to also. Now you look at this example. I can English. What is the verb here in this sentence? The verb is can. But this sentence is meaningless. Why? Because can, as I told you, is what? It is an auxiliary verb, modal auxiliary verb, which can never be used independently. It has to take help of the lexical or the main verb. And so the better sentence, the correct sentence, is that I can speak English. Now the sentence is meaningful. So the verbs can, could, may, might, should, would, all these modal auxiliary verbs can never be used independently in the sentence. So friends, I hope that now the whole idea is clear what different types of verbs are. Let me recollect the whole discussion by saying that the verbs can be divided into two different categories. Lexical means the main verbs, and auxiliary means supporting verbs. Lexical means dependent, independent verbs, and auxiliaries means dependent verbs. Lexicals can be different types, regular and irregular. What are the regular verbs? When you use ed to make the past form and past participle form of the main verb, like cook, cry, play, these are regular lexical verbs. But when there is no norms, when no rules are followed to make the past and past participle of the verb, it is called an irregular lexical verb. Say, for example, speak, listen, think, run, stand. All these verbs are irregular lexical verbs. What are the auxiliary verbs? They are always dependent. They are known as auxiliary verbs. But auxiliaries can be of two types, primary and modal. Primary, there are three: be, do, and have. Primary auxiliaries sometimes act independently in the sentence, sometimes act dependently in the sentence. But modal auxiliaries are purely dependent on the main or lexical verbs. Again, verbs can be divided in a different manner: transitive verbs and intransitive verbs. Transitive verbs are what? Transitive verbs always take one object after the verb, and intransitive verbs do not take any object. Say, for example, I take tea. Take is the verb and tea is the object. So take is a transitive verb. But when I say I sleep early, sleep is the verb and early is not an object. So there is no object in this sentence. That's why sleep is an intransitive verb. In the same manner, verbs can be divided into finite and non-finite. Finite verbs means the lexical verbs, main verbs, which change as per the subjects and different tense. I sing well, Raju sings well. So sing becomes sings when there is a change in the subject. So these are known as finite verbs. And non-finite verbs are those, they look like verbs, but they are not actually verbs. Singing is my hobby. Here, the verb is not singing, the verb is is, right? And singing is the subject which look like a verb, but it is a non-finite verb. So friends, here I come to the end of this discussion on different types of verbs. I hope the whole idea is clear to you. If you have any doubts or questions, do write to me in the comment section of this channel. And please share this video among your friends if you really liked the presentation. Thank you. Thank you very much.